morning, guys. Super excited to be at Barbell Brigade. I've been training at my home gym alone for the longest time, so it feels good to be around people, and there is no atmosphere in the world that replaces the one here. And we don't even have to wear a mask, so we can talk to people, get hype, and actually hear what people are saying. And today, I'm also training with two training partners that will also be competing with me in July. So it's gonna have that team atmosphere instead of training by myself. And today we're gonna hit a heavy bench and then a bunch of back and shoulders bodybuilding. So we're gonna have a great training session. And also, thank you guys so much for the support on the recent Ethos collection drop. A lot of you guys love the oversized tees, and because of that, a ton of them are sold out. Thank you so much. We do have a few more sizes left. And this one, this is the principal tee. So make sure, if you want to get it, go check this out. I love this one. I love this color. It goes with literally everything. Got it with the forest camo. So thank you guys for the support once again. We do have a few sizes left in a few of the styles, so make sure to barbellbrigade.com and go check that out. So I have to hit a heavy single on the bench at an RPE 7. I think for a 2 second pause, I think I'm gonna go for maybe 320, 335, around there, we'll see. And then after that, I do a back off set for a triple, minus 10%. So everything else is very calculated. The other one are also designated numbers. And then after that, I'll probably hit a bunch of pull-ups, shoulders, chest-supported rows, all bodybuilding. But yeah, benches, the heavy bench is what I'm looking forward to. This bench is fucking awesome. I'm so used to my shitty bench in my garage. So my full equipment didn't come yet, but I still need a bench. So I bought a cheap one, like $50 one off of Amazon. And when I'm setting up, you could just feel the whole thing cracking up. I mean, cracking underneath. So for something to feel stable, it feels so good right now. Your main goal when setting up is to try to get as much pressure on your neck and the top of your shoulders as possible.
Okay.
That's the main thing. When you're benching, even though you're lowering the bar to your chest, imagine you're also bringing your chest to the bar.
Okay.
Yeah, like that. That's gonna get a strong bottom position. And then also your feet. It doesn't really, I mean, you wanna tuck it back as much as you can, but if you can't, that's fine.
Yeah.
The feeling that you want is almost like you're trying to slip the bottom.
Oh, okay.
So that's how you know that all of your weight and tension is up here.
Okay.
And that way your body is like stiff and rigid, and that's just the platform.
Yeah.
The other side thing, like after my bench, I go roll out my back.
Really?
So I roll out my back.
That's why
it's just
like your squat.
It's like a squat, tight, and then after you're done, the way your feet are tucked too. It's really stable.
Yeah, I'm trying to get like...
No, they're, it looks stable.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, really stable.
Because like at first, I would have my legs out.
Yeah.
I couldn't get that like... So I kind of have to pull back.
Yeah, what you have right now looks really strong, yeah. The only other key would be the same thing as him is if the as the bar is coming down, try to meet it.
Oh, okay.
Because I mean, I make this mistake too. And then pretty much everyone it gets heavy, they make this mistake a little bit. But if your chest is like this, you don't want the bar to come down and then flatten you out. Because then you're losing tension. So you want to actually like look like that almost, if you can.
Yeah, yeah. I'll try it.
One, two, three. Let's go, Albert. Three, one. Two, three. Nice. Dude, you gonna bench 500 today or what?
Looks like it.
What the
Jesus
fuck?
Hey.
Dude, that was fucking fast, dude.
Nadim, on a training program.
Damn.
That's crazy.
Have you ever done like 23 and me before?
No.
I think you're like 100% type 2 muscle fiber.
Really?
Yeah, you're explosive.
Really?
Yeah. I think you would excel if you keep stick at powerlifting. I think you would excel.
So, I'm not on steroids like these guys are. I'm just kidding.
What's on steroids? You heard it here first, guys.
I was on steroids, dude.
It's called the strength stack.
Yeah. Strength stack, 100%.
What do I do?
Let's go, Justin.
Nice and tight.
Everything,
it's like instant.
Hey, but I still beat you on that race about the beach.
I know, dude.
You still
what? I beat Justin and Don and Mindy at the beach at Venice.
So, in a race?
In a race, in a sprint. Got them.
Three, one, two, three.
Oh. Wow, that's fast.
Was it?
Do you think the shirt helps?
The shirt? Oh, dude, of course. Just like, it's not restrictive, because what people don't know when you wear tight shirts, it's taking 50 pounds off your bench because it's so tight. This one's loose, so the animal can come out.
So it's like 100, it's actually 100% raw compared to the cheaters that wear a tight shirt.
Cheaters, man. Cheaters in tight shirts showing off their muscles and restricting themselves.
Not humble at all.
Not humble at all.
I was at like 275.
Oh shit.
And I didn't hear the up, and then someone else yelled up, and I was like, oh shit. And I was completely like last game.
I'll give you three commands.
Okay, yeah, okay.
And remember, bring the chest to the body.
Yeah, yeah.
Without lifting your shoulders up though.
Okay.
Your shoulders stay pinned, but your chest comes up.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Let's go.
One.
Oh, are you?
No, you'll
okay.
Go lift.
One, two, three.
Start. Press. Okay. Wrap. That's good. So it'll be something like that.
Okay.
But a little bit slower because we're 70.
Shit, all the hairs here. Fucking the hairs.
All the refs watching like, fuck that fool. Fuck him on me. Let's go, Justin. Same thing. Weight on the neck and shoulders, and then chest meets the bar.
One, two, three.
How much are you going to hit today?
I don't know. I'll take 315. This was my last weight that I hit last week. My shoulder does feel better a little bit. So I'll take this, review the video, and then make an intelligent judgment on what the next, what the fuck am I saying? On what the next weight should be.
Why are you not using a block anymore?
Well, I realized the block is actually what people use to train, especially if you do like west side and variations. So I wanted to bring my own, so I don't take up the equipment.
When was the last time you saw someone do block bench?
I haven't seen anyone use the blocks in a long time, actually.
We actually have the one that you can just attach to the bar.
Oh yeah. I should put my phone in that one.
Hey, Justin, you got me, right?
One, two, three.
Left, left.
call Sean and ask him to review it.
Right? I know. Hey, coach.
Oh man, that's pretty good.
What are you thinking?
Like
Spartan. And then what do you want to do?
I probably want to do 405, because it looks pretty good. But I'll probably go with like 325.
That's smart.
I should just put 405 on anyways.
Start. Press.
That pause, like,
don't dive bomb it.
Okay.
Yeah, like, if you can come down, it doesn't have to be like super slow or waste all your energy.
Yeah.
But when you dive bomb, you're gonna have to have waste energy needing the bar to stop.
Yeah. Gotcha.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Take a breath. Big air. Yep. There you go. Yep. There you go.
Better than your last set.
Better than your last set.
Woo. That felt good.
That was a good one, dude. Yeah. And also your fall path is all the same. The last one, your first one with a good rep, and then something happens to your shoulders where your elbows came out a little more. But this one, all of them look the same.
See, that's what I think I was telling you. Like, it just feels like something's happening in between.
That, that means you have to dig your shoulders in and don't let them come out. Yeah, yeah.
Well, that's why like that grip like actually helps. It's like typically before, like if I didn't have that, like just benching with that alone just like helps me like stay put and stay like tight. Because without that, I would kind of slip and kind of lose, you know, kind of like lose grip. And then
slipping and going backwards and flattening out, your elbows start coming out too.
Yeah.
Is that good?
That was great.
Awesome, thank you.
Good, that's good. Really good.
Good. You're good.
Oh, hell yeah.
That was good.
My squat went up significantly.
Good.
I really
good.
So, like, that's
good. Nice.
There you go.
Good.
I got that pause.
It's fine. Next time, don't be like, oh shit.
My bad.
Oh, fuck, I said.
Like, after I did my one,
two, three.
Got it.
So I would set up where like where you lay down, maybe have the bar be where your chin is.
Yeah.
By the time you're done arching, the bar should be kind of where your eyes are.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Load all of your weight on the back of your shoulders and on your feet.
Yep.
Get a nice tight arch and then push up right here.
Yep.
Yep.
One, two, three.
Pause first one.
Yep.
A little lower.
What's up? Good.
Hell yeah.
There you go. That already moved better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Felt better too.
Nice.
There you go.
Big air. Big arch. Chest of arms. Nice. There you go.
Hell yeah.
Very good. The last rep, you rushed a little bit, and that's what was off. But the first four were really good.
Yeah, they looked really good. Just you guys tweaking like little things, like I just already feel like the weight is moving the way it should be.
Yeah.
Without like limiting injury, like, and just like with confident form, right? Like before I was just going like row sets, like just hit a couple bench, but then like actually get strong, right? Like I was just always plateau.
Yeah.
But then with this, like even with the Dean's program, I just feel a lot stronger, just like healthier. Like I move better, everything, like little risk, low risk of injury, like just the way I'm moving.
and just these little cues that just help me, like, okay, boom. I kind of like Diddy's in the Marine Corps, like, hey, hit this, hit that, hit this, and it just comes up smooth.
Yeah, like general best practices, there's about like 80% of what everyone should do.
Yeah.
Then there's like 10-20% that's individual differences.
Yeah.
So like, you'll see people world record bench like this, world record bench like this, world record flat, world record craziest arch you've ever seen.
Yeah.
But generally, even the person that's flat, that person is trying to get the best arch they can get. So there's 80% of best practices, and it's like me and the DM are just looking at what you aren't doing yet.
Yeah.
And the other part, you kind of like experiment and figure out for yourself.
Sure. And that's what's been so helpful, because then like, although I'm taking, it's like adding more tools in my toolbox, like, hey, do this, but like, you know, like add this and do this, and, you know, and it just helps so much, like, during this whole like time I've been prepping for this, like when I'm at home, I'm like, okay, these cues, and like, boom, hit it like this. And even if it's like a little light, but it's just getting that movement down, just helps so much.
Even just the bar.
Yeah.
Practicing with the bar helps too.
100%. The bar.
One, two, three. Yeah, because like if your arch is like this, it's in your best favor to be at the peak of it. You know, you want to like get as close to the peak, but also it's also determined by your grip.
Yeah.
So the wider you go, the higher the bar is going to be, just because the way your body's built.
Yeah.
The narrower you go, it allows you to get like closer to here. So you try to find somewhere within this range.
The medium, right? Like that good medium.
Yeah. Felt really good. Felt really good to be on an actual powerlifting bench. My form feels really dialed in. 325 felt really smooth. My back offset of 290 for three felt smooth. And then I did four sets of three with 285, and they all felt like a Smith machine. So I felt really, really good. Had a really good bench day. Now it's on to the fun stuff, bodybuilding.
Okay, Jason.
I wish, dude.
Hey, what the hell? Hey, show up.
That's why you're gonna get hurt for powerlifting. So what's this workout now?
So now we're just doing pull-ups, three sets of 10 to 15, just to work on all the antagonistic muscles to the bench. So your back, your lats, your upper traps, your shoulders, everything on the other side, so you don't end up with this powerlifting body and injure your shoulders because your shoulders are rolled forward all the time. Every accessory that I do, I like to do something with two hands, and then I like to do something where they call unilateral, so I can fix any symmetrical issues. You know, a lot of us have a dominant hand, so I like doing these. So I like doing pull-ups with both hands, because I can't just rip out a one-handed pull-up. But on dumbbells, on rows, since I have a choice of so many weights that I can choose, I can fine-tune the type of training that I want. So for example, for the first two sets, I went pretty heavy with the hundreds. On my last set, I'm gonna go with the 50s, so I can do a higher rep and also pause at the top and have a way better contraction.
Yeah.
This week we saw a martial art in there. My star face smile like goat. And I have a big diamond in my yellow hair.
So right now we're doing upright rows. When it gets this close to the meat, even though I really love overhead press and other like vertical pressing movements, I try to save my triceps and my elbows, so save my joints and my muscular fatigue for the bench press, because I do bench press 4 times a week. So all other like shoulder or upper body accessories, I keep it away from pressing. So we did some side raises on the cable with low impact, just really flexing the muscle, and now some upright rows. Because you can go relatively heavy, still really tax the muscles while saving the elbows.
How important is biceps for powerlifting?
So the importance of biceps and powerlifting, I think, has been a highly debated subject. In terms of sport specificity, where for the bench, the pressing movement, pressing competition movement, many people think biceps aren't that important, and some of the best powerlifters in the world don't have big bodybuilding style biceps. But your biceps are the hamstrings of your upper body. So if you think about it in that way, where if your upper body is the identical flip of your lower body, like your chest is your glutes, your triceps are your quads and has different heads, just like your quads, then your biceps are your hamstrings. And think about how important your hamstrings are to your squat, how it controls the descending motion. In that regard, I think biceps are really important because it alleviates a lot of elbow tension, elbow pain, helps with stability, touching your chest, and also having strong biceps, in my opinion, helps you in the deadlift, where you can have more control over your arms, better grip strength. So in my opinion, I think it's really important.
Wouldn't your shoulders be your glutes, and then your chest be your penis?
So this could be your ball sack, and this could be your scrotum, but it depends on if you look at it underwater or not.
Aren't they the same thing?
I think you're right.
How about, how was the training today?
Dude, the training was freaking awesome today. I don't know if it's because I got to like train really hard without a mask, because I feel like it restricts half of my air, or if it's the team environment, we're pushing after each other, helping each other with cues, spotting our movements, or just the intensity in the room, but everything was perfect, from the music to the team to the atmosphere. It just felt so good. 325 moved really good, and I told you guys earlier that I had an injured shoulder, and I didn't feel it at all, not even a little tweak, which is always so good. So that helps me feel like the next bench session is gonna be even better. Finished up with some bodybuilding. I did 3 sets of 12 to 15 on pull-ups, dumbbell rows, side raises with the cable, just working on some of the machines I don't really have in my garage gym, so I could really like stimulate the muscle differently and help with contraction, upright rows, concentration curls, and I felt really, really good. Tomorrow I'm coming back and doing a powerlifting workout, so I don't want to over fatigue myself. I have to squat pretty heavy, deadlift pretty heavy, but today's upper body workout was awesome. So it feels really good to train with people with the exact same goal, and not only the same goal, but at the same competition. Because I remember how nervous I was at my first powerlifting meet. If you guys go back in videos, I think 2013, like no one was there to help me. I didn't know anything. Like I signed up for Raw, but then I bought Wraps because I thought Wraps was Raw, and then I found out that was Classic Raw. I didn't know anything. Like I was just jacked up. So to be able to pass on some of the knowledge I have to Justin and Albert and help them out, help them with the commands, like that really, like not only does it help make me feel good that I was able to pass on the knowledge, but also like ingrains the same thing I need to know too. Because even as a more experienced lifter, there are times I still skip commands, you know, like you just get so excited and you forget. So it's cool to pass on that knowledge so that I can relearn it too. Yeah, so my workout's really good. I'm really excited for this meet. This is the first time where I haven't really fucked around in the whole year. You know, I'm not running a marathon. I'm not doing jiu-jitsu or doing Muay Thai or anything. Everything is focused on powerlifting, perfecting my technique and also getting lean and bringing my weight down, and my training is feeling really, really good. So I'm super excited for the meet. Thank you guys for watching me along all my journeys, regardless of what it is. I love you guys so much for always supporting me in that way. And for those of you guys who are looking for the best pre-workout and the best flavor, we just dropped it not too long ago, our mango guava. Go to barbellbrigade.com. And if you've been seeing these oversized tees on Instagram, they're super fresh, super dope. This is one of my favorite ones. Our principal tee with our ethos on it, strength through domination, strength through humility, dominate humbly. See you guys next time. Peace.